So Daniel Hume from Satalia, you've just finished your keynote presentation about AI and the ways that distribution and hotels can possibly can work from it and leverage it.
Yep.
It was a really, really interesting presentation, especially given that AI now in the modern world that we're living in is going to have such an influence on many businesses, not just hotels.
Yep.
During the speech, you touched on a couple of things that I'd like to ask you to dive a little bit deeper into. First one was the ethical issue and having explainable algorithms as such. You used an analogy or an example of what would you say first, a baby, or what would you say first from a burning building, a baby or $1 billion? Then, and most people would probably lean towards the baby, but you gave a very interesting alternative to that. For those that weren't in the audience, just go into that a little bit more.
Absolutely. So as we are building systems that are making decisions about our everyday lives, we need to understand how these systems are making their decisions and what their objective is. And the example is, if there's a burning building and there's a crying baby in the burning building and a suitcase with $1 billion, what do you save? And most people absolutely will say they'll save the baby. And but the question is, how many babies can you save with a billion pounds or $1 billion? And you can save significantly more babies. So if you had a robot that, for example, saved $1 billion, you need to understand why and how that robot is making its decision. And if its objective is to maximize life expectancy, then it will argue that it can invest in curing malaria and save many, many more babies. But I would argue that we haven't agreed yet as a species what our objective function is. Mm. So many of these philosophical and ethical questions we need to address by saying, what are we trying to achieve as a global species?
Yes, it's an interesting dilemma in many ways. You also spoke about talent strategy and the decentralization of decision making. With that philosophy, how do you think within a service environment that hotels could best apply that type of principle when it comes to this?
Yeah, I was just saying that my company has about 100 people, and we don't have any managers or hierarchies or KPIs. And I know that many organizations, many industries are very hierarchical, but our premise is that there are people in our organization that can make decisions much better than other people. Rather than having hierarchies, what we do is we operate very much like a swarm. We profile people using our digital footprint, and then we identify who are the right people to be making those decisions and how do we empower those people to make those decisions and make them accountable. So it might be that there's a cleaner in a hotel that can actually answer or make a decisions much, much better than a manager or something like that. And the question is, how do you identify that individual? How do you empower them? And the use of data, the use of AI will unlock that talent and that capability.
Mm-hmm. Now, the other thing that a lot of industries are very cognizant of is the reality that AI will most likely remove jobs that most people have done for the last, let's say, up to 100 years because of the need for that. So obviously there's a great concern amongst people that are doing those types of jobs. Do you believe that through AI that there will be new jobs created that will be able to take or fill that gap? Will there be that opportunity through the technological evolution of AI coming in?
I think there's a blend when it comes to job losses and job creation. So I think that over the next decade, we're probably going to see more jobs created because of these technologies, investing in these technologies, and companies thriving because of them. But I would argue that we could probably take any specific task that a human can do, and we can build an AI that can replace that task. So if your job requires only one sense, one specific thing, pressing a button, something like that, those things are susceptible to automation. For jobs that where you have to harness lots of different things, tactile and vision and sound and empathy and all of these things, they're going to be less susceptible to an AI removing them. But the concern is that if we do remove people from whole jobs, we now can get AIs to do things that were traditionally only in the domain of human beings. So with the industrial revolutions that have happened in history, people have been freed up from their jobs but have been able to retrain and do new jobs. The challenge is that if all of those future jobs are taken away because AIs can do them, then you could end up having lots of people out of work, and I'm not quite sure that governments are quite prepared for that future problem.
Well, there is also the theory about this proposal that every person moving forward in the future will have a basic income that will cover, so that if you don't work, you literally will be provided with by a basic income. and that ultimately robots and AI will just do everything anyway.
Yeah, that's a very interesting interesting future, and I'm currently investigating universal basic income. I'm much more interested in a concept called universal basic needs, which I don't think has been coined yet, but it's how could we create a planet whereby we use automation to ensure that everybody has access to nutrition, to healthcare, to shelter, to education. So you're all born into a system where have all of the food and everything that is provided for you just to provide for your basic needs, and then you can figure out what you want to do. And I would argue that if we really put our minds to it, we could completely automate food production and food delivery and have solar system, solar panel and all that kind of stuff run that without needing human beings. But it would mean that we would need to cooperate and collaborate as a global species. But I do think that is a future that is possible, and that's a future that I would like to try to create.
Yeah, certainly. Okay, now coming back to the hotel side of things, from our perspective, when we have a lot of new companies coming into our domain that are leveraging modern technologies, and AI is one of those things, and that can be considered under revenue management solutions, could be under distribution when it comes to selling rooms online. Where do you see the main opportunities that hotels would really benefit from AI?
Yeah, there are those three parts of a business where you can apply technologies, and so one is the front profiling customers, understanding their needs, all of this kind of stuff, predicting market demand, etc. Then the other side as well, which is optimizing your operations, making things more cost effective, blah blah blah. But I think that also AI can be used internally to help free your staff up, to enable them to be better customer facing, etc. I think it's probably easier right now to create business cases at the front part, because that's where the money is. It's more difficult, I think, to say if we make our employees happier, how will that impact our revenues? But I think it's important and crucial to understand that AI is our systems that are able to learn and adapt themselves. And I think that if we can build systems like this, then we can unlock opportunities at each part of the business significantly more than just automation.
Okay, great. Now, you also mentioned in your speech the concept of a digital twin. That kind of piqued my interest as well. Can you talk more about this, and again, where do you think hotels could learn from that?
I think a lot of industries are going on a digital transformation at the moment, where they're trying to get all of their data together. And what they're ultimately trying to do, I think, is create a simulation of their organization, where they have sensors on all of their important devices and equipment and tracking things, and even their people will have sensors so they can understand how happy they are and whether they're productive and things like that. But ultimately, they're trying to create a digital twin of their organization, because I would argue that intelligence is synonymous with adaptivity. So if you have a digital twin of your organization, you can run simulations to say, if I spend more marketing money here, how would that impact my entire supply chain? How would it impact the customer experience? If I can have that simulation, I, as a business leader, can ask lots of questions, run lots of hypotheses so that I can adapt my organization more quickly. And that's what you're trying to get to.
Excellent. Okay, and then just finally, hotels traditionally are reluctant to allocate a lot of funding when it comes to technology. Do you think that really now that they should start to consider more funding towards AI-based solutions? And if so, what would be a recommendation in terms of how much?
I think there are a number of different dimensions to this. So I do think that investing in AI now is incredibly important, because it used to be that you could kind of be a fast second mover, but I think that those organizations that are investing in technology will be able to outpace people that come second. The challenge is, how do you attract talent? Not necessarily the technology, how do you attract talent to create those innovations? And so I would argue that if you're a hotelier or whatnot, it's important for you to have a very strong purpose, because if you want to work with a third-party AI company, or if you want to attract talent, AI talent, they're going to want to align themselves with a bigger purpose. So it's not about the technology. I think there's lots and lots of technology out there. It's about being able to unlock that technology using talent, and good AI companies to work with, they're expensive, so it is an investment. But of course, you can start out with proof of concepts and all of this kind of stuff. But I think it is important for industries to start investing in this, investing smartly, though.
Excellent. Daniel, great to talk to you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Excellent.